previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel.
No fucking chance.
I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Yes.
Let's leave.
For real, if you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Aww.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your... birth mother.
What a twist.
I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Yep, let's do this.
Chloe. I'm right here. Good. I need you.
In high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long. She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape. Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. Was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again. What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel? It was true, we kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her. That she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. But after all the people she hurt, all the lives she destroyed, I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world, the chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again, and again, and again, to keep you safe.
Dang.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. I mean, people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel, I think I need to lie down.
So sad. Poor Rachel.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Heck no, you can't.
Rachel? I need some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her.
Go cuddle up next to her.
Hey, Rachel. I'm glad you're here, Chloe. Of course. This light needs more light.
That was so pretty.
Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight. I could get grades like this. I just don't want to. Hey. Ready for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first.
Hey. Check it out. It's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars.
I want that for my house.
It reminds us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see. Because we're blinded by what's in front of us. Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies. But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
Not at all.
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that Aww. Other woman. My real mom. She's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust. I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination. Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
So pretty.
The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me, I think I need to see her. Is that wrong? Of course not.
I don't think so.
But It might be tough to track her down.
Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon. But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
I think I might be able to fix up that truck in the junkyard.
Really?
I'll give it my best.
Yep.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak,
I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.
Right. That is really pretty, though. Oh, I love Ariel's costume in this.
Dad, I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go?
Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
Don't you mean my memories? I don't think you remember after you're dead.
Touché. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Fine. It's the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about the whole world being a stage, so might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Dang, they put blood and everything. Made it a little gruesome, didn't they? All sad and everything. Seriously, someone booed her? That's messed up. Ray Chicken? Like, oh my god.
Wait, what the shit? Has someone been going through my room? Doesn't seem like Mom.
Sort of looks like that.
She wouldn't leave a mess like this. Wait.
David.
David?
The cunt.
That motherfucker. Whatever. I don't have time for this shit. I've gotta help Rachel. Okay. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. He might also be totally pissed about Damon's money. I've got to get this exactly right. I can do this.
You got this, boo.
Price.
Oh, Frank. Eager much?
Where's the money?
Jeez, would you relax? I have it with me, okay?
I'm coming to get it right now.
I have a favor to ask you.
You can't be fucking serious.
I need to find that woman who was in your RV yesterday. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I'm trying to help a friend. It would mean a whole lot to her.
The girl with you at the mill?
Yeah.
I'll be in the junkyard in 2 hours. And bring the fucking money.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real...
asshole.
That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into?
Love. You best believe
it. Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing.
Look. This poor room.
Is Mom playing music? Hmm.
Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. My towel's... No awesome pirate towel. Lots of washcloths. No towel. I truly hate seeing so much of David's shit. Gross. Score. Can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my life.
Yes. Especially hot showers are the best thing ever. How do you know David didn't use that soap? Like, I'm just curious. Makes me want to go dye my hair blue.
I need new clothes.
She just need a lot of stuff. Sorry, but with all that bending and
what
moving
do
around,
I feel like wearing
that towel would have fell.
Crazy ass day.
I think a skull. Yeah, see, I just dry off and then hang it up to dry.
All right.
I got time to sit there and fight with a towel
One
around
last
me.
Thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
Slim to none.
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess.
At least they seem happy right there.
You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Right? Yeah,
Mom,
just send me
actually
flowers.
Looks pretty happy right now.
You know, I gotta cook for me. Feels bad, man. I know, right?
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did, but this is something different.
And that shirt. Oh, I haven't seen it in ages.
I know, right?
I was out of clean clothes.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't think you'd be coming home. None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe.
You just holler at the food.
Coming home was a smart decision.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh.
Right. His name is Cuntface.
Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you. It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
I don't think this is the best idea.
You already promised.
Chloe, I've made an agreement with your mother to trust you from now on.
Really?
What?
What does that mean?
That was a shocker.
It means that from today forward, I'm going to take you at your word. So, if you say you haven't been smoking or drinking, then I'll just leave you be.
The idea is you should feel comfortable here, Chloe. David's not going to question you, and neither am I.
It's not his place to anyways.
David's lying to your face, Mom. He searched my room.
What?
You didn't know? Detective Dickwad here went through all of my drawers and my bed.
It's what you asked me to do. Make sure she's got no drugs or alcohol for her own good.
Oh, my goodness, Chloe. I'm sorry.
I thought that... I'm sorry, Joyce. I didn't know this would upset
Chloe
you.
It's Chloe who deserves the apology.
Well, Chloe, I'm sorry that I violated your privacy. I did it with your best interest in mind.
Sure you did. You didn't do crap for anybody's best interest.
Okay. I accept your lame apology.
Right?
Chloe.
I agree. Like...
What? I really meant it. Good job.
Asshat.
Can we be done now?
I get props to Joyce. She's trying so hard.
Wait. One second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were going to get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through.
I'm sorry, but losing a friend is not the same as losing your dad.
So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here.
Oh,
why
yeah.
Don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
I'll be the nice one.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right.
I'm still waiting for the part where she says, give David a chance. I'm pregnant.
What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck. Work with me here.
This looks like me. Oh, impressive. Like I'm so short.
Damn it.
That too.
Better. But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. It's not like I need a manual, but I'm really glad it's here.
pretty loose. How can I tighten it? This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap.
Like her hands all look gross? Like...
I can definitely see some problems. Just need to match them to the... The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. That should help keep shit distributed.
That's one way.
Well, put it. Fuck. Go back from whence you came.
Whoops. Keep hitting A instead of B.
Loose. How can I tighten it? Much better.
Dang, I think I can do some of this stuff in person. Shoot.
Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be. This thing is gunked the fuck up.
Cause that's how you get the gunk out, just blow it.
Maybe.
Ew. I want stick that in my mouth like that. I know I bothered to turn that on.
What do I see? I know.
And also on Raven, look at that.
This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. Thank you.
There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course. Please, I need you.
And it took like 5 minutes to fix. That's what I'm talking about. And she actually knows how to drive a stick. That's rare.
Yeah.
I know, right?
Hey! Junkyard Queen! Where are you at? Hey! Holy shit! Your hair! It's so...
badass. I was gonna say hot. But, yeah, badass too. Hey! Not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
You're practically a certified mechanic now. Even have the shirt to prove it. Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
What do you think? We're not dealing with a couple of dime bags anymore, Chloe. Where's the money?
It's right here. Obviously, I was gonna give it to you. You don't have to be such a dick about it.
You heard what happened to Drew, right? Maybe try keeping that in mind when you talk to me.
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing. Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Huh. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you, but he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know, right now, why you give a shit about this woman?
Why do you care so much?
Because fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is. Now.
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your pro-
Rachel? As in, Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know?
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
Oh, shit.
Oh, you fucking bitch.
Hey. Alright, be safe heading home.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's had a surgery, and now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
I don't know. Everything happened so fast. Do you know who Damon Merrick is? Or why he hates you?
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is.
Sarah's start over brother.
And tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
I think he wanted to scare us, so he'd stop asking questions about his business.
Is that how it became violent?
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
I don't know. Maybe he's seen her before.
What happened next?
Damon had a knife out, and we all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something, but when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive. First of all, my department's been after him for some time. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
Hey.
Steph, how's Drew?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay, sure. Definitely.
I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up.
All right, then. Thank you.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
You here to see Drew?
Yeah. How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. Now, Drew's hurt, of course. But, I'm between jobs, so got plenty of time to visit. You know?
Yeah.
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now. I have a question maybe you can answer.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well, guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
No. Sorry. This weekend was actually the first time I really hung out with them.
That's all right. I appreciate that you've been keeping my boys company. Drew's got so many hopes for himself riding on their knee. It seems like he's been even more driven lately. I think my work situation's disappointed him. Both of them. Actually, in different ways. Sorry I'm laying all this on you. I've been trying to keep it light in there.
That's okay.
Nice of you to listen. Do me a favor. Don't worry either of them with... Oh, excuse me.
Hey!
You made it.
Oh. Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Drew. How's your knee doing? Do they think it's gonna heal?
I'm not sure, actually. It's too early to tell.
Sorry to hear it.
It's all good.
Love the hair, by the way.
Pretty cool.
I bet you'd look cool with a little color.
Yeah? I'll have to think about it. Maybe something red? Hey, any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
Rachel's stable. She'll probably wake up soon.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
What happened?
She got stabbed in the arm by demon fucking Merrick.
Seriously? It wasn't because of me, was it?
No. Somehow, we've got our own shit with him now.
That's crazy.
Fuck that guy. I wish I could get my hands on him.
Drew, chill out, okay?
I'm headed out. Everything okay in here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Don't have too much fun now. Try to keep it appropriate for the hospital.
Bye, Dad.
See ya, Pops.
Maybe I shouldn't have mentioned Damon. Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready.
I can graffiti his cast. That's messed up.
Hey. Sorry for losing it there. It's nice of you to come by.
Yeah, no problem. Easier than you coming to me.
You know what? I'm kind of tired.
Oh. Oh, right, right. I'll leave you alone.
I wanted to snipe his cat. Take his pudding. I can't take Homeboy's pudding. That's just mean.
Alright. I'm gonna head out.
It was really great to see you, Chloe.
Agreed. Don't be a stranger, okay?
Yeah?
Tell Rachel we're rooting for her.
You bet.
Been assigned to you. I never authorized that he be seen by.
I was assigned because Nathan was becoming quite upset.
So they sent a psychiatrist because my son was upset.
Holy shit.
Please, Mr. Prescott, your son needs serious psychiatry.
Hey. Chloe, I can't even express thank you so much. I'm sorry. I'm a wreck. I stepped out to get some air. Rachel doesn't need me crying in front of her. Your hair. I almost didn't notice it.
Oh. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
I bet Rachel loves it. I can't imagine what I would do if we lost her.
Me too.
You've grown so close, haven't you?
Yeah.
Do they not know they're lovers
yet?
It's
weird to think we just met a few days ago.
When you meet someone who changes everything, you just know.
Well, hang in there, Mrs. Amber.
I will.
Oops.
Dad, I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
It really hurts.
Shh. The pain will pass. Chloe's here. You want me to stay?
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
I'll come back in a little while.
My guardian angel. I saw Steph earlier. She says hey. Steph's so cute. But not as cute as you. Stop.
I mean it. Rachel, I'm sorry.
What?
What for? You're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard.
What? Shut up.
You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. I'm so sorry.
And you saved my life. You saved my life.
I almost lost you. I can't believe I almost...
You're not getting rid of me that easy.
Good. Happy that your dad's here?
I mean... I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe.
Like on Mount Hood.
Would you do something for me?
Anything.
Sarah. My mom. It's so weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her.
I figured you would.
I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay. But if she is, will you find her, please?
You really want this, don't you?
I do, Chloe. I really do.
Then, of course, whatever it takes.
I bet my dad has her number. Maybe in his office. Our house key's just under the mat. The code is 0722.
To your... Dad's office? 0722.
Yeah. My birthday.
I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are.
Yep.
Thank you, Chloe. For... Everything.
Hey, Elliot.
Hey! Wait. Your hair, it's different.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like it. It's nice. I like your shirt, too. You never told me you were into cars.
Guess you don't know everything about me.
Sorry I bailed on seeing the Tempest with you. The whole thing just sort of happened.
No. Not a problem at all. So, what's going on with you?
I don't even know where to start. At the moment, I'm here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here? What happened?
I think she's keeping that private for now. She's okay, though.
Well, that's good. God, I guess I'll stop by after I see Drew.
She probably wants privacy.
Oh. Right, of course. Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
I'll make sure to keep you posted. Right now, I'm here to take care of Rachel.
Chloe. I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately, right?
So what?
So, obviously, something is going on.
I swear,
can't take a hint, but she's not gonna talk to him.
Everything's really okay.
Wait, jeez.
Okay. I trust you. Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks. Anyway, see you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
Hi, welcome back. About time. Just kidding. Miss Elliot getting friend zoned like hard. I know, right?
Hello?
I like how she's sitting here driving her truck around with, like, no tag, no car insurance, like... It's crazy. That was me, I'll be done, got pulled over and locked up and everything.
I need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that can help me find her. I'm not gonna be able to smash my way through this one. Hopefully there's a key around somewhere.
I know, right? Like, dang.
James sure keeps lots of files on people. Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Seriously.
Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before? James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
Like, she shakes the snowball, it's like so weird.
It's the big one. What do we have here? I should check the computer or some of those files laying around. Arcadia Bay's least wanted. Arcadia Bay's least wanted. James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom. Best dad? That stuff is all politics anyway. Found you.
I actually thought it was underneath the snow globe.
Welcome to Shadyville. Sarah sent all these letters, and James never gave them to Rachel? Sarah? So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night.
Just a little bit.
I have to know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah. James is working with Damon Merrick? This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sierra is. But how do I get him to tell me? Shit. What do I say? Hope James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon will tell me where Sierra is. Unless I send him a picture. Shit. Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just take a wild guess and see what he says. Or maybe there's some info on the case hanging around the office. Could this be the evidence? Damon and knives seem like a solid bet. Did Damon really shoot someone? Guess I shouldn't be surprised. Huh. If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
That's never good.
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
I wish we get snow. I want snow.
Oof. Better not touch that again. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching. Arcadia Bay's least wanted. Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right. This'll be tougher than I thought. Maybe I should dig around for some evidence. Payment?
He's needy as hell.
Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be?
Okay.
More sherry. I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory. I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash. Holy shit. Fuck, that's Sarah. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her? Does James even know what he's doing? Okay, I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
Elliot?
Hey!
Elliot, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here? This is Rachel's house, right?
Did he really just follow me here? Did you follow me from the hospital?
I did. I'm worried about you.
I'm fine. You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe. What is...
Elliot, put that down. You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, God, what have you gotten yourself into?
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
I know, right?
Honestly, Elliot, you can judge me all you want, but it's pretty fucked up that you're here right now, and I don't have time for this.
When?
What?
When will you have time? For me? You have all the time in the world for Rachel. I'm so sick of you not seeing who Rachel really is. When will you realize what she's doing to you?
Elliot, just take a step back.
No! You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
You don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
Stop suggesting that she's somehow bad
for- The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble. And you get suspended.
Rachel was there for me. She did everything she could to protect me.
I guess it wasn't enough, huh?
You don't understand.
You weren't there!
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in? She let you make a fool out of yourself.
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before—
I've been quiet long enough! Look, Rachel is an amazing actress. And I don't mean on stage. She's fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
Elliot, I promise. No one is manipulating me.
No? Just look where you are now. A high school dropout. Hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy. It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened.
Look,
just
I hear you. I appreciate the concern.
I don't think you do.
Elliot.
I'm the one who cares about you, Chloe. Me, not Rachel. It's time you saw the truth.
What does that mean?
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
What the hell?
Elliot, please. I know you're
upset.
I know,
right?
But...
I'm not upset! I'm trying to help you.
Look, I'm sorry, but I really need to go.
Why did you make me do that? Can't you just listen to me?
Elliot's gone full-blown crazy. I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me! We have a lot to talk about. And I don't care how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad? Let's talk.
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
You mean here, specifically? Like, the Amber House?
I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
You're the one who's keeping me here.
Crap.
At the Arcadia Bay D.A. James Amber's house.
You're acting strange. What's going on?
What? Nothing.
What are you? Ugh, you bitch! Can't you see? I just want to help you! You're going to assault me now? That's how far you'll go to protect Rachel? This is what I'm talking about.
No! You idiot!
What the fuck?
Better run, dickbag. Cops will be here any minute.
Well, that's one way to get out, I guess.
Thank you.
about to die, isn't she? Jeez.
Destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life, and he's still lying.
Hey, being a dad's tough.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I just don't know anymore. That's what makes it so horrible. James Amber, the perfect dad, and James Amber, the scheming asshole, would act exactly the same around Rachel.
Oh, sweetheart, you're a terrible liar, so I couldn't have been much better, right? Would you love me less?
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Problem is, I'm dead. So how am I supposed to tell you anything?
That's gonna look smartass. I mean, it's true, but that's kind of smartass.
I guess it's better this way, not knowing.
Then I'll always be the perfect dad?
Not many people get to say that. No way. My ride, my tunes. Am I seriously going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel. Crazy.
Hella crazy.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real. Shit. Is that blood? Frank?
Frank! Shit, this is bad. I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom.
That, like, how is she supposed to help Rachel's mom? She's just a kid. I guess a guy who just stabbed her friend and messed up Frank.
Where the hell is Sarah? Glad to see the bone made it. No more beer. No more time. I've got to keep
This might come in handy.
Going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
I just want to meet my daughter. Can't you understand? Why does
he... Your daughter? Jesus. So that's what he's worried about. Can't let the public know. The mother of his daughter. Some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to.
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture. So that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
Oh, shit.
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
Can we just talk about what's going on here?
Okay. What should we talk about?
Whatever James told you, Sarah doesn't deserve this. She didn't do anything wrong.
You think I give a shit about what she did? My job is to make problems go away. And she's the problem.
Look, I just think... No!
Talking's over.
Leave her alone.
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Get away from her!
I said shut the fuck up!
No.
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now. What do I do with...
Damon! What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man. Fuck you.
Sarah. Rachel. Your daughter. She...
No, right? Like, major ouch.
Sarah? Chloe Price. You know who I am?
I saw you in the play. You were funny.
Thanks.
Sit.
Sarah, are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry for-
Rachel can never know.
What exactly can't Rachel know?
What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with-
He's a piece of shit. And I promise that-
Rachel can never know.
Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar!
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever.
And just, what is James protecting her from? You? She wants to meet you, Sarah.
No, she doesn't. She wants to meet her mother. I can never be that for her.
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken, Sarah.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away?
You're here now. That's what matters.
What do you know?
I know Rachel needs you. I... No loss. I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and was it?
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
I read your letter to James. You beat this before. You can beat it again.
No. I can't. I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I just... I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so.
Ugh.
That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't
deserve... It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
I can't lie to Rachel. I won't do it. She trusts me. And I don't want to ruin that.
If you love her, you'll lie to her. Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her. Protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt. So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Wait! I'll take care of her, you know.
I believe you. Goodbye, Chloe.
Why is she not under the blanket? Like, isn't she cold? I'm just curious.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order.
Fuck yeah.
We never actually escaped. Did we?
We've got time.
All the time in the world. So, how did everything go?
Rachel, I've got to tell you something.
Hey. I gotta protect her. I can't tell her the truth.
What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny, you seemed so confident. I really thought you'd find her.
Yeah. Me too.
Liz, I know I wasn't alone in
Maybe
that.
We can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet.
Of course. I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much.
How do you know that?
Because why should she be any different from the rest of us?
We brought her flowers.
Thank you.
Well, that was an interesting ending, at least, I guess. It was pretty good, though. It was good. Thanks, everybody, to drop by to watch the end of this one. As of right now, plan on being back next Tuesday for the bonus episode. So make sure you hit that follow button so you don't miss out. Love you guys.